What's up? I'm Adam.
I'm Ami.
And we have a special treat for you. We are going to look at the new Power BI embedded playground. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. And I have the pleasure of being joined by Amit Schuster. Amit, what do you do on the Power BI team? You are actually on the Power BI product team, correct?
Right. I'm the product manager for Power BI Embedded Analytics.
Is it just all Power BI embedded, or is it specific aspects? Or
in Power BI Embedded Analytics, we are in charge on both solutions for developers, the embed for your organization and embed for your customers. And we're also in charge of all the user APIs.
Awesome. Ooh, that's all the fun stuff. I love it.
Right.
All right. So Amit, I know you've been hard at work and the team's been hard at work. All of the Gen 2 stuff has been coming about and the Power BI embedded front has not been slow either. We've got an updated Power BI embedded playground. I did a video not too long ago looking at the new Contoso Sales embedded application sample. I know you had pointed me that way and walked me through some of those. I think you were involved a little bit in that as well.
Yeah, I also did that demo. So.
Awesome.
Both the demo and the playground are like my projects. So that's nice. Really exciting to see them going out now.
So if people have questions, they should go to you.
Yeah, they can.
The Power BI embedded playground, it's been around for a little while. I know I've used it in a lot of demos. I've been pointing people to it for years now. It's gotten a little outdated. And so I'm excited with this new playground. I think you're going to walk us through and just show us what everything changed with it, right?
Right. So we did a really big makeover to the playground where we enhanced the developer experience and also the experience for non-developers where everyone can get information and knowledge about Power BI Embedded Analytics.
Love it. All right, enough of all this talking. Let's head over to your machine and actually see what this looks like.
Yeah, definitely. So what you can see now, this is the Power BI Embedded Analytics Playground. And you can see here all the different experience that we offer. We have the developer sandbox, we have the Explore Our APIs and the showcases. Today, we're going to focus mainly on the developer sandbox. So let's just go and click on the try it. And now when I'm going to the developer sandbox, I have a dialogue that asks me, how would I like to start? So you have here two options. The first one is to use a sample report, which is just the report that we give you to play with. The other option is to use your own report, to bring your report from the Power BI service. So I'll just go and click use sample report. When I click on that, I have here this dialogue that shows me how to drag and drop code snippets to this code editor. So let's just go and for example, I'll just do set slicer state. So I just drag it and drop it here in the code section. And you can see that I have here the code that set defines the filter. And afterwards, it also calls the slicer set slicer state to set this filter. And now I click on run and you can see that the slicer here, the date slicer, will get updated to filter between October to November. And what is really new and exciting about this playground is that now you can edit the code yourself. So I can go here in the code snippet and let's just change it to filter from April. And then when I click run, the report will render again and you will see that I have a different slicer filter.
Wait. Hold up a minute. You're telling me that not only can I drag and drop things, but this is actually almost like a full developer interface where I can actually play with that code?
Right, that's correct. So you can edit all the JavaScript code that you can see here on the screen.
Nice. And so just for folks, if you weren't familiar with the old playground, in that it did have the code there and you could copy and paste it, but you couldn't really edit it on the fly and make those changes like a real developer environment. So this is a big step forward.
Yeah, this is really cool. And now let me show you how I bring my own report. So I'll just click on here on start over and then I choose select report. Now I'll redirect to Azure to sign in. And now you can see I'm signed in and you can see my picture here at the right upper corner. So I just write here my report. So let's bring the Tailspin Toys workspace and I click on embed. And now my report from Power BI service, and you can bring any report that is in a workspace. You can bring it here and embed it, and you can see here that I have my report embedded in the playground. And again, I can drag and drop APIs and modify this. So let's just go do some set filters, getting the report filters. And now I need to change the table and column to match the table of column and of this report. So let's just go and look at one of these visuals and let's just filter the region. So I'm filtering the region table and let's just filter it to, for example, Midwest. So let's do a table region and column region and the value will be Midwest. And I'm clicking on run and this will filter now the report to Midwest. So that's super cool.
That is awesome. This is great for folks if they want to get up to speed with Power BI Embedded. Maybe they don't know anything about it and they just want to try it, see what APIs are available, how they work, but also like even if you are developing a project, of being able to quickly prototype some things and then get them over into your actual application without mucking and messing up your production code, right? That's exactly. is that kind of the goal of this?
Yeah, you can go here, bring your own report, experiment, see the different APIs, change them to match your report metadata, and see everything works like really beautiful.
Awesome. And then the some other things I noticed in there, there's the ability to explore the APIs. You still have the showcase items in there that were there before. So if you want to see certain capabilities of Power BI Embedded, that is there, correct?
Yeah, definitely. So we took all the showcase and really give them a really good upgrade. So now you will have all these new showcases. So the subject of the showcases is the same, but if, for example, I just choose the customized report colors and mode, you will see that now we have this Contoso app. So I can see everything in an app context, and I can even choose the theme here. So everything is nicer. And we give you all the source code of these showcases on GitHub. So you can just click here on the left side on get resources, and you will be redirected to GitHub to the showcase code, and there you can see all the different files you need.
And then the old embedded playground, I know that was available on GitHub as well. Is this playground available on GitHub also?
So no, sadly, okay. We only share the showcases code.
Okay. And then also the Contoso sample app. There's a link in the Contoso sales app to the playground. And
right,
so that's available on GitHub as well. All right. So Amit, where do people, like if they have feedback on the actual embedded playground itself, is there a way for them to go and do that, to provide that feedback?
Yes, definitely. So if you look at the right upper corner, you can see there is a smiley button. So if you just click on this smiley button, this is our satisfaction survey. Currently, it will just take you to an MS form where you can leave all your feedback to us about the playground.
Awesome. And so Amit, is there any call to action for folks that you want out of this video?
If you're watching this video, just go to the playground, play around, go see all the different experiences that we've built to you. You also have the Learning Center where you can get to all of our documentation and samples and tutorials. So just go check it out, and I hope you will enjoy it.
And let us know in the comments also what you think. We'd love to hear that as well. All right, if this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick, myself, and Amit, thank you for watching, keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.